today I'm going to be showing you how to make something that I put on Twitter. You're going to like it. So I've never started doing this screen before, so it's going to be 800 by, wait, hold on, that flopped. 800, nope. There we go. 800 by 800 pixels. What else we got? Yeah, that's about it. So 800 by 800. Always name your files. So I'm going to name it grid. You can name it anything you want. Anything. There's no there's no rules. Let's just freestyle. Okay, so what we got? All right, so I'm gonna make a black background. That's the first thing you start off with. I really haven't explained it, but the reason is I can't really explain it. Terrible at explaining things. I can show you though. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna lock that in place. So what I did there was just get a square and make it the size of the artboard. I'm gonna make a new layer and I'm gonna get a stroke. Like seriously, you should follow me on Twitter. Yeah, I'm gonna be posting a lot of stuff on there every day. Well, I'm gonna try to every day. If I don't do it every day, then then there's problems. So we've got a stroke. That's 3 points. And we're gonna use the transformation tool. So we're gonna go to the top, object, path. Nope. How did I do it before? Oh yeah, effects. Then you go to transform. This is gonna be a pretty quick tutorial. So we got one stroke. What we're gonna do, we're gonna oh yeah, copies. So in this section you just choose how many copies you want. Let's say I want 20. I can put 20 there and just go to preview and oh, that's horizontal. Right, so we want to go vertical. Like, you know what, you actually can go horizontal if you wanted to, but for this tutorial I'm just going, oh, is it a tutorial? I'm not really explaining things really well, but hopefully you're gonna understand it to the way that you want. Anyways, so we've got 20 lines. I'm gonna make it 25. All right, that's looking good. What I found out about, I'm gonna have to use the cursor. All right. Yeah, what I was saying was, what I found out about having too many lines is that it can hurt the eyes. So try and go for as least as possible, but enough so that it looks complex, if that makes any sense. So that's perfect for now. Yeah, that's perfect for now. I don't seem really sure, do I? But trust me, I'm absolutely sure I know what I'm doing. All right, so I'm gonna go to object, expand appearance, and that should make each one a stroke. So you can still edit the strokes as you go along. So if you want to increase it, you can. If you want to decrease it, you can. But here comes the main event. We're gonna go to the envelope tool, which is in effects, hopefully. Nope. Object, definitely. See, I'm still learning. The reason why I haven't done an introductory course to Illustrator is because I'm still learning it myself. Who knew? All right, so if we go to the envelope tool, oh yeah, first off, if you want to use the envelope tool, you need to select the object you want to use and then use select make mesh. Oh, came up on the other screen. All right, so create mesh, and hopefully you don't have two screens like me, but for now we've got four rows and four columns. So as you can see, if you turn on the preview, you can edit this section here. So I like it how it is. Yeah, so I'm gonna click OK. And what else we gotta do? All right, so that's how we do it. So you can just move it about, just play around with it and see how it turns out. Just mess it up and see how it turns out. Trust me, I was playing with it every day until I found out that people liked it. All right, so that looks pretty sweet. All right, so what we're gonna do from this point is open Photoshop, copy. I told you I was rusty. So hopefully when I make more tutorials, then I'll be more fluid with it and it'll sound better. So yeah, I'm gonna head into Photoshop. Slowly waiting. I actually thought IMAX were meant to be fast. where are you? All right, there we go. All right, so I decided to load in the other screen while we're waiting. We need to think of a name for the project. So I'm just gonna call it Waves, like I did on Twitter. Make sure to follow me on there. And yeah, I'm just gonna make a new layer or new path. I'm gonna make it 800, so just make it the same size that you made the Illustrator project, because we're gonna copy it inside. So 800 by 800, resolution, make it as high as you can. Highest I would say is 300. Any higher and it's just over the top, and under that is not as good as 300. So 300 is the best. So let's create it and create. All right, perfect. So let's go back to Illustrator and we're just gonna copy it. Copy. And we're gonna go to Photoshop. We're gonna make a dark layer. The reason I don't go with like black, like jet black, is because sometimes it doesn't look nice. It depends on the type of what you're doing. I tend to go for more off black. Like I actually choose a color first and then go to the darkest bit of that color. So like blue, I select blue and just go down to the bottom blue. It's close to black, it looks black, but it's more colorful, if you get what I mean, if you get the drift. So I've chosen the color of the background, so what I'm gonna do is Control V and paste it as a smart object. You can do it as any of the other ones, but if you want to edit it again later on line, then use smart object. And you'll be able to go back into Illustrator while double clicking and you'll be able to edit it and it will refresh in Photoshop, which is pretty cool. So I'm gonna press OK. And I'm gonna resize it into the square. All right. All right, perfect. All right, so what we're gonna do is press Control A. And we're going to center the vector smart object to the center horizontally and vertically. And we're pretty much done for the wave bit. The best thing to do right now, or what I did in my previous project, is to add some color. So what you need to do, or what you could do, I'm not going to tell you what you need to do, but what you could do is go to the gradient tool in Photoshop, which is pretty cool. I've already got my color set. If you want to copy this color, then I'll leave a project file in the description, but for now I'm gonna change it to something that I may like. I may not like it, but you know, I just want to sh- show you how I did the first one. So obviously when you head into Photoshop gradient overlay, you get two colors. You get maybe black and white. So if you change one color to one color and another color to another color, I'm not really explaining this, but let's try and explain through actions. So what I'm going to do is set this to purple, which is already done. This is going to be set to blue, and I'm going to set this to a lighter blue. All right, that looks perfect. And if you want to introduce more of the blue, just try and move this cursor bit here. And if you select this, the lower color, then you can increase that one as well. All right. And if you want to increase it some more, you can just change the scale here and it should work. All right. So that's basically how I did it. Envelope tool, bring it into Photoshop, use the gradient map, gradient overlay, and yeah, it turns out pretty good. Anyways, that's the end of the tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and comment, and I'll see you in another video.